Friends, in this session, let us understand how this cash credit or overdraft facility operates. We know the cash credit is funded or given only to support the lockings of the business money in stocks and receivables. But now the question is, at what value the banks will consider the stock and receivable? As far as the stock is concerned, it will be considered only at cost, and receivables is concerned, it will be considered at billed value. Why the stock is considered only at stock, too it may have profit element? See, profit is an opinion and it may be realized, may not be realized. So, or to be on the safer side, the bank will consider only the stock. But as far as the receivable is concerned, which has both cost and profit element, it can be realized because it is already billed to the customer and becomes a legal claim for the customer. So the bank would consider only the cost for stock component and realizable value for the receivable component. Okay. Now, in stocks itself, if you see, there are three classifications. One, there will be something called raw material. The second one is process stock, and third one is finished goods. So the raw material you will put into the manufacturing process. So those stock which are in the manufacturing process is called process stock, and those which has been converted into a finished product is called finished goods. Fine. So all the three will be put together and will be called as inventory, and banks would decide some margin on this inventory, right? Because the margin is the portion where the owner has to contribute. So the bank will not fund entire inventory. The bank would tell the customer, look, you have to bring some margin, because margin is what the owner has to contribute. So it will deduct margin from the inventory, and only the balance will be considered as drawing power. And why this drawing power important? Because it is only the drawing power which the customer will be able to draw. Fine. So this is on inventory side. We'll move on to the receivables. See, as far as the receivables are concerned, what is important is the cover period concept. The banks will go by the cover period in receivables. You can give n number of bills as receivables, n number of debtors as receivables, but what the bank would see is, what is the cover period? Only those debtors who are within the cover period will be considered by the bank. What is this cover period? Cover period is nothing but the normal credit period extended to the customers. So the bank will study the credit period of the customer. Say you take 30 days or you give 30 days credit period or 45 days credit period, the bank would freeze that credit period in its sanction and would say the company has a practice of giving only 30 or 45 days. So for cash credit facility also, consider only those debtors which are in the range of 30 to 45 days. That's why the cover period concept is very important. So what the bank will do from this receivable, it will consider only those debtors which are within the cover period, and on that debtors it will deduct margin. The margin is supposed to be the owner's contribution, like what we have here. So from that, once the margin is deducted, it will give DP or say drawing power, and that would decide the eligible loan. So now we can understand that from stocks DP will be calculated, and from receivables also DP will be calculated, and these together constitutes the eligible loan amount which can be drawn.
Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you like this lecture. If you wish to learn more on the areas related to this topic, check our comprehensive course. I have shared the details and link in the description below. Click, sign up and enroll. I'll see you inside the course.